Welcome to Blackboard Basics for Faculty, a sabbatical project in collaboration with the Faculty Center for Student Success at Saddleback College. This is a 7-part video series, and today we will cover Part 4, Assignments. These videos are specific to the South Orange County Community College District, but they are designed to help everyone using Blackboard. The Blackboard interface used in these videos is version 9.1. Interface design changes with certain updates, but many of the items covered in these videos have remained constant or been improved with each update. These videos are to help faculty who teach face-to-face classes use Blackboard to enhance their courses. If you are a student looking for Blackboard help, please see Blackboard Basics for Students, linked below. Part 4, Assignments. In this video, we will cover 1. Creating assignments with the Turnitin option. 2. Embedding videos from YouTube. 3. Creating assignments with the Blackboard assignment option. Number 1. Creating assignments with the Turnitin option. Let's start by creating an assignment with Turnitin. Turnitin is a feature South Orange County Community College District pays for to be integrated into Blackboard. I use Turnitin for my assignment submissions for the date and timestamp, plagiarism checking, and ability to place comments and feedback directly on the student's assignments, as well as use a rubric within Turnitin. We'll be covering the basics of setting up a Turnitin assignment in this video, and looking at the assignments in Part 6, Grades, Grading and Viewing Assignments, but there are lots of resources for faculty on Turnitin.com, and the Faculty Center at Saddleback College can assist with more detailed instructions for Turnitin if you are interested. To create a Turnitin assignment in Blackboard, make sure your edit mode is on and start on the assignment page. Click Assessments, then Turnitin Assignment. Select your assignment type. This is the Turnitin creation page. Select your assignment type. Paper assignment, peer mark assignment, or revision assignment. Select your assignment type and click Next Step. For Blackboard Basics, I select paper assignment. New assignment. Here is where you will create your new assignment and turn it in. Create your assignment title. Think about your naming organization and enter your point value. Then choose to allow files that Turnitin can check for originality, plagiarism, or to allow any file type. Then choose your start, due, and post dates. The post date relates to the availability of students to see graded papers. I make the post date the same as my start date. I click Optional Settings, and under Special Instructions, here I type. This is an example of an assignment using Turnitin. To submit assignment, click View Complete below to upload your assignment. Then I look over other optional settings to make sure they are what I want in terms of allowing submissions after the due date and generating originality reports. There are a lot of options in Turnitin that go beyond the Blackboard basics for this series. If you are interested in this, please visit the Faculty Center for Student Success if you work at Saddleback College, or reach out to other technical divisions in your institution for assistance. Turnitin also has some great resources on their website, turnitin.com. Click Submit and view your Turnitin assignment. Here is the Turnitin assignment link. It is purely for submitting assignments. If you're going to use Turnitin, you would need to have your assignment instructions somewhere in Blackboard for your students. In this case, we could use an item, build content, item, like we did in the Part 3 video for the syllabus, and then have Turnitin as the place students submit their assignments. If that was the case, you could change your Turnitin assignment name to be in line with your item. This is what I do with my classes, as I like using Turnitin and all its features. Number 2. Embedding video from YouTube. As a bonus, I am now going to show you how to embed a YouTube video in Blackboard. On the assignment page, go to Build Content, YouTube Video. Now search for your video. I type in submitting a paper to Turnitin and click Go. A list of videos shows up and I see the one I'm looking for titled Submitting a Paper to Turnitin Assignment. Student Training. I can preview this video to make sure it's the one I want, and then select the video by clicking Select. The Create Mashup Item page opens up. Here is where we can add and edit information about the video we are embedding. Number one, add YouTube content to course. When I have a video, I always include video in the title before the name of the video. Number two, mashup option. For the view, you can choose thumbnail, text link with player, or embed video. I choose embed video. I also click yes to show YouTube URL and click no to show YouTube information. Attachments, I have no attachments here. Four standard options, permit user to view this content, yes. Track number of views, yes. Select date and time restrictions. We've covered this in past videos. I don't put restriction dates on videos like this because I want students to have access to them at all times. Number five, submit. Click submit. Here is your embedded video for submitting a paper to Turnitin. Number three, creating assignments with the assignment option. Make sure your edit mode is on and start on the assignment page. Click assessments, then assignment. This is where you can create an assignment. Start by giving your assignment a name. Think about naming your assignment in a way that is explanatory to students. You should do this with Turnitin assignments also. Is it homework, an assignment, a test, quiz, or exam? Let students know in the name. Also think about numbering and overall naming. It helps to let students know what they are looking for in the grade center. We will see that in part 6 of this series. Number 1. Assignment information. I name my assignment, homework, course design 1, submit here. The name of our assignment will end up being the submission link, but some students don't realize that, so I've added submit here to the name. Now the instructions. Most times, I attach the assignment and create a link like I did on the syllabus video. I also include instructions on how to upload assignments for students in the instruction box. Here I type, this is an example of an assignment in Blackboard. To view the assignment, click the attached file, homework, coursedesign1.pdf, above. Here is a backup link to the assignment if the file above does not open. To submit assignment, click homework, coursedesign1, submit here, above. I utilize the spell checked option, change my font and text size, and use the bold and underline feature, as well as bullet points, to fancy up my text. I covered this in detail in the Part 3 video, Announcements and Syllabus. Number 2, Assignment Files. I browse my computer for my assignment file and attach it. Then I modify the link title to be in line with the assignment title and include click here, just in case. Number 3, grading. Under grading, I enter the possible points. I choose 100. You can see there is an option to add rubric. As that doesn't fall under the Blackboard basics, I'm going to skip it in this video. If you are interested in this, please visit the Faculty Center for Student Success if you work at Saddleback College, or reach out to other technology divisions in your institution for assistance. Number 4, availability. Like the Part 3 video on announcements and syllabi, you can control the availability of when students see your assignment. Check Make Assignment Available so students can see the assignment. If this is not checked, students won't be able to see the assignment. Number of attempts. Check the appropriate box for your assignment. Allow single attempts. Allow unlimited attempts. Number of attempts, and then enter the number you would like. I check Allow single attempts. Limited availability. Here you can decide the dates you would like your assignment to be visible. This is in addition to the Make the Assignment Available checkbox. You must have that box checked to let this work. Using this feature allows you to work on multiple assignments at once and create the dates you would like the assignment to be visible to your students. Number 5, due dates. Due date is the date you can have your assignment due. The date shows up in the gradebook and will mark assignments turned in after the due date as late. Number 6, recipients. Here you decide if you are grading all students individually or group of students. To do the group of students, you need to create groups in Blackboard, and again, that is a little beyond the scope of these videos. I check all students individually. Number 7, submit. Then I click submit. Here is our assignment using the assessment assignment feature. Of these two options, I use Turnitin for my assignments because of the plagiarism checking, feedback options, and rubric integration. Just my personal preference at this time. This completes part 4, assignments. In this video, we covered 1, creating assignments with the Turnitin option. 2, embedding videos from YouTube. 3, creating assignments with the Blackboard assignment option. Our course went from looking like this to this. Thank you so much for joining me for Blackboard Basics for Faculty, using Blackboard to enhance a face-to-face class. Leave any questions or comments below, and I will do my best to get back to you. Please join me for part 5, where we will cover contact information and resources and links.